The third eyelid flap technique for supporting corneal ulcer. The cornea is a transparent, avascular, non-pigmented part of the outer fibrous protective coat of the eye. It is rich in nerve endings and even soft touch to it is painful as a result of the high amount of nerve endings. It is not uncommon for this sensitive tissue to be attacked by what is called corneal ulcer, a loss of corneal epithelium followed by progressive lysis and loss of corneal stroma. And the condition may be aggravated by perforation of the cornea with subsequent loss of vision. An important surgical treatment of corneal ulceration is to support the cornea till the ulcer undergoes complete healing. And one of the simplest procedures is third eyelid flap technique. The third eyelid is a fold of mucous membrane located at the medial canthus, and it moves laterally when the eye sinks under the effect of pulling by a retractor bulbi muscle behind the eye. This nictitating membrane is strong, wet, and its inner surface is rich in lymphocytes, immune cells. Accordingly, it can be used to support the cornea during the active phase of corneal ulcer. How can we apply this technique to the animal at our clinic? Simply, it is performed by passing the needle and the thread around the vertical member of the teleter cartilage of the third eyelid through the two angles between the horizontal and the vertical members of the teleter cartilage, and this will make the stitch stronger with lower possibility of laceration. Then after the two ends of the silk thread pass from the inner aspect of the upper eyelid at the dorsolateral corner temporal region of the eyelid to end at the outer surface. Then they are threaded through a button to avoid lacerations and to permit easier untying. And they are tied after pulling the eyelid to a desirable limit. The tie here is not like surgical knot. It is formed in a manner that it can be untied daily to examine the ulcer. This will permit supporting of the ulcer, keeping it warm to stimulate enzymatic action to initiate proper healing, and supplying the ulcer with a huge amount of lymphocytes. The technique has some advantages, like it is technically less complicated than conjunctival flaps. It requires no expensive equipment, nor it requires high experience, and any well-qualified veterinarian can apply it. And above all of this, it allows the veterinarian to check the corneal ulcer daily by untying the knot to examine the ulcer, then retie the knot. Give it a chance and try it.